Welcome guys to Science of Hangover. Now before we start, I would like to say that the science of hangover is not that well understood. There are a lot of mechanisms which go into the digestion of alcohol and the effect it causes. When I take up liver, I'll be sure to mention all the 15 things that alcohol does to actually damage the body. But in this, we'll see one of the main components which will be leading to all that headache and nausea and all those things. Now, what happens in a hangover? Alcohol is consumed. Alcohol gets converted to aldehyde. Aldehyde gets converted to acetic acid. And given the fact that liver is your largest gland in the body, yes, it does this work efficiently and completely good. Now, the problem does not come when we are digesting the alcohol. The problem comes after the digestion, when we reach the final step of acetic acid. You can't keep an acid inside your body. No, you're supposed to get it out. You're supposed to get rid of it. So you have to excrete it. Yeah, that's when your renal system comes in. Now, renal system, it can't excrete pure acetic acid. That would be injurious to your urinary tract. So what it does is it dilutes it. Okay, now to dilute this, it requires a lot of water. May not believe, I think the ratio of water used to alcohol consumed is 1:4. Okay, so for every 100 ml alcohol which is consumed, 400 amount of water is required to excrete it out. So what this leads is, after depletion of the water from your ECF to dilute this, your body still requires water to run everything. Your body composed of 60% of water. Out of that, you should have 1/3 in your ECF and you should have 2/3 in your ICF. So the fluid from ECF is used to dilute the urine, which contains the end product of alcohol. So what your body does is, to compensate for the loss of water from ECF, it's going to take in water from the ICF, which leads to shrinking of cells. Okay, now most organs, depending upon how much water content they have, they co-op somehow, because your body is an endurance machine, it will adapt somehow. And you know, your brain being such a soft organ, when it undergoes shrinking, a very peculiar effect comes in. So this is the brain. It is attached to the meninges. So you have your pia mater, then you have your arachnoid mater, then you have your dura mater. Okay, when water is drawn out of your brain, when the brain undergoes shrinking, okay, there will be increased gap between the meninges and the brain, which leads to a kind of pressure pull. That's the reason what causes your headache. The pull by the meninges, so the meninges are adherent, the outer meninges are adherent to the skull and the brain is shrinking. So this tug of war in between is the cause for your headache. Okay, and when a person moves his head around, when he's in state of hangover, when his brain is shrunken, that's why he feels that, what do you say, pain when his head is directed toward one side, because the brain has shrunken down, so it's not sitting properly inside the cranial cavity. This is the main cause for that headache that a person gets during the state of hangover. So while looking at this, the cure is simple. Okay, so you're getting dehydrated. Main aim is to rehydrate. Not just with water, you need to compensate for all the electrolytes which have been lost when the urine was excreted. So you need glucose, you need sodium, you need the chloride ions, potassium to a certain extent. And it's advised to take vitamin B, which is available in the form of either vitamin B tablets themselves or multivitamin. Okay, so this around somehow helps alleviate the symptoms of hangover, And NSAIDs like aspirin and paracetamol are shown to help, but given the fact that we don't properly understand the entire concept of hangover yet, these are somehow aimed at alleviating the symptoms and speeding the recovery, but are in no way a surefire method. And I hope you guys read the disclaimer. I'll see you in my next video.